G'day and welcome back to my Clinic of Marvels. Today we are learning about muscles. Let's get moving! Now, when you think of muscles, what's the first thing that comes to mind? Probably a bodybuilder, someone big and strong, maybe The Rock. We kind of think of big biceps that can lift a lot. But the muscles you see in the mirror aren't the only ones you have. You have muscles all over your body, and they can do a lot more than just lift things. Oh, sorry. I better grab that in case it's important. That phone's never rung before. Ahoy, hoy, you lucky person. No, I don't know any weightlifting vegetables. A muscle sprout. Beyonce, give me strength. Jack, did you prank call me?
No.
Anywho, we actually have three main types of muscle. Number one, skeletal striatal muscle. These are the muscles that we use to move around, lift things, walk, bend, and jump. They are also known as voluntary muscles. Like, you know, when you volunteer to help at the animal aid, you choose to help at a charity because it's voluntary. It's entirely your choice to do so. So voluntary muscles are muscles that we choose to move. So we decide we want to bend our arm and we make the action happen. Number two, cardiac muscle. This forms most of the walls of our heart and great vessels. This muscle is involuntary, which I'm sure you can guess means we cannot actively decide to contract or relax it. It just does so automatically, which is pretty fantastic because we've already got enough to worry about, I think. Number three, smooth muscle. This is also involuntary, so we don't have conscious control of it. This forms part of the walls of most of our vessels and hollow organs, so your stomach and your guts. Today we're going to start with skeletal muscle. Skeletal muscles have a red fleshy belly which contracts to create movement and a white piece of connective tissue that attaches it to bone. We have muscles all over our body, in our feet, our hands, our lips and face. Have you ever wondered how your eyes are able to move? They don't just roll around in the sockets. We have little muscles that contract to move them. Contraction means to tighten or put tension through the muscle. If you imagine a skeleton just on its own, how does it move?
I normally just call an Uber.
Jack, for what reason would you possibly need an Uber?
To visit my mates. It gets lonely when you have no body.
Take the elbow joint, for example. It's a classic hinge joint. For anyone not familiar with what a hinge is, go have a squiz at your bedroom door and you will see something like this, or this, which function much the same way as our elbow. We have a muscle that attaches on one side of the joint and the other. When the muscle contracts, it gets shorter, and this brings the two opposing sides closer together. That's how we move. A great way to show this is with Anatomy, Arts and Crafts. Yeah. All right, here we are in the craft corner. Today we're going to be making a kicking leg, a fully functioning leg that kicks. Here's what you're going to need. Some brads, not Steve's, not Kevin's, but brads. Some bobbins. Some string. I got some nice pink string from Bunnings. This is actually a bricklayer's line. Some cardboard, some scissors, a pen, some red paper, a couple of zip ties, and something from the cupboard that's sort of round and heavy, and you'll see why in a minute. Let's begin. So the first thing you're gonna do is go onto our website and have a look in the Anatomy, Arts and Crafts section. We've got templates. So there's a template for this one. So download and print out the template, and then we're gonna use it today. Start by cutting out the pieces in the template. Now, I forgot to add that it would be really useful to have a couple of little push pins. You know the pins that you use on a cork board? So I'm going to trace my template onto the cardboard. And then all you have to do is cut the template out of the cardboard, the one that you've traced on. Now I've got a really thick piece of cardboard here, but you could just use like a cereal box or something thinner, that might be easier to use. Alright, so I've got my cardboard bits cut out. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add some muscles. So here's how it should be laid out, right? This is going to be the thigh, the top part of the leg. This is going to be the lower part of the leg, and this is going to be the foot. And I want to put a muscle on the top and the bottom part of the thigh, and this is going to show how the muscles work to move the joint at the knee. So I'm just going to stick these bits of red paper onto the thigh, and that's just going to represent the muscles that I'm wanting to put on there. So we have to use our push pins to make some holes in our cardboard, and the templates that are on our website have exactly where you need to put the holes. Okay, so just follow the template on where your holes need to go. It's really important that they do go in the right spot. This is where our brads and bobbins come into play. So firstly, we need to connect the legs together, the parts of the leg, so the thigh and the lower leg. And we're going to use a brad. Then we need to connect our foot to our lower leg. Okay, so now we've got something that looks a lot like a leg. We've got some muscles on there and it's held together pretty well. If you want to know how we make this leg kick, then tune in for part 2.